So far in our cinema booking system, we've got the ability to pull up a menu, which is down here, and choose between either add a booking, so book a film basically, or search by film. And we've used functions to call up these programs here. So the search film function is up here. Okay, I think I changed the function name of that from the last video just to make it a bit clearer. And then we've got the add bookings function here, and this is the one that we talked about earlier, where if you pull it up, it will ask you to enter in some details of your name, what film you want to see, and when you see it. Now we can improve this a little bit, because currently in the old model it will generate a booking reference, okay, just here using the random randint. And previously I had it set between 1 and 100. Okay, now I've just set it between these two numbers, and I'll explain why shortly. And what the booking reference does is generates a unique number for a person booking a film. Now the problem is, obviously we had it set between 1 and 100, and there's the obvious possibility that two booking references could be the same. So we can be a bit crafty, and we can change our code a little bit to make sure that it's very unlikely two numbers will be the same. Okay, and this is how we do it. Now, I've added this at the top of the code. Okay, so I've got a new list called data, and we've got the same code here as we used up here. Okay, all right. Just there. And this is the code that will open up what is in our CSV file, which is over here, and it will put it into a new list called data. Okay, and we're going to use this list to search through our CSV file. Okay, a bit like we did here when we were searching through column four to find a particular film. Okay, so it's the same code essentially. So what we've got is we've generated, in this case, and this is just a test, remember yours will be set from 1 to 100, but I've generated a random number between 35 and 37, okay, and we've called it booking ref, and we've converted it into a string, because we can't save that the integer into a list which will then go to a CSV, and this is our search here. So we're saying column 1, that's our variable name, and column 1 is here. To us it's column 1, remember, to Python it's column 0, which is why we have the 0 here. And this creates a loop which will loop through column 0 in our list called data. Okay, and if you remember, data is all of the data from this CSV. Okay, so all of this has been transposed into this list here. So it's searching through all the data in column 0, which for us is the numbers. Okay, and what I've done, I've put a little print statement here just to check it's doing that. Okay, you don't need that in your final program, but that just tells me it's looking through here. Okay, so it will print everything in column 1. Alright, and we can just test that out if we run the program quickly, and we should see all of those numbers here if we select book a film. Okay, so let's just see, there it is. Okay, so there, that is the print statement, which prints out everything in column 1. So I know that column 1 is working. Okay, it's printing out, and it's printing out and searching through all of column 1. So what we're saying here is, if booking ref is in column 1, okay, so say for example we run the code and the number that's generated is already in column 1. Okay, so it's already there. We obviously don't want two numbers to be the same. So we have to then generate a new number. So we're saying, if that number is already in column 1, or column 0 for Python, we're going to turn booking ref back into an integer, because we need to do a calculation with the number. And we're going to make a new number called booking ref 2. Okay, and this time I've set it to be random between 1 and 1,000. Okay, and I've got then a new variable which I've made called new booking ref. So this will replace the old one. And I've said booking ref, okay, let's say that's number 35, times booking ref 2, which will be a random number between 1 and 1,000. Okay, so it will be very unlikely that there will be a similar booking reference in that column now. I've converted it to a string so we can put it back into the list and back into the CSV, and I've appended it to our list called bookings, okay, which is currently empty up here. And then after that, we've just got the normal stuff that we had previously, okay, so the inputs and appending to that list called bookings. Okay, so in other words, if it finds a number that's the same as already in the column, it will generate a brand new number. Now, down here, we've got an else. Okay, so in other words, if the number is already there, this will run. Okay, and it will generate a new number. If the number is not already there, then this bit of code will run. And you can see it's pretty much exactly the same as up here. Okay, so if we run this and just see what happens, we might have to run it a couple of times. I'm just going to close the CSV so it doesn't get confused here. So if we select one, okay, so we can see there that it's obviously chosen a number. In my case, I set it between 35 and 37. It's probably chosen either 36 or 37. Now, because that number is already in that column, there they are, 36 and 37, it's now generated a new number. So it's generated 27,898. And that code, so this part of the code is running. Okay, so if I go ahead and enter all of this stuff here, aliens again, whoops, and Monday, you can see that I put a little capital in there, which will mess up my searches for the films, but we'll talk about that in another video. So hopefully, if we go back to the CSV now, we should notice that, where are we? We should notice that Bobby George has gone into it, and he's got this brand new number. Okay, good, there he is. Okay, so this is quite a crafty way of reusing some of the code but changing it slightly to make sure that you don't get two booking references are the same. So if you're using a program where you've got any kind of ID number where you need a unique number, this is the code to use. It may be, there is a possibility obviously that it could, two numbers could be the same, but then you could go ahead and just increase the numbers in each thing. So I could actually just change that between 1 and 10,000, and then you've got a huge chance of two numbers not being the same. Okay, so that is one way of making it so you have a unique number in a sort of booking reference or ID number scenario.